degrees in the Tennessee mountains as the search turning desperate for a two-year-old little boy who disappears hiking with grandma. Focus now turning to local registered sex offenders, 28 of them to be exact, within just a 10-mile radius of where this tot goes missing. Straight out to Michael Quander with CNN affiliate WREG. Michael, thank you for being with us. Tell me about the search.
Well, Nancy, they actually are out there right now in a field of that too far away from where I am right now at the Pinson Baptist Church in Pinson, Tennessee. Now, right now, they're using law enforcement crews from across the state and even outside of the state, including as far as Florida, Missouri, and some other places like North Mississippi as well.
Everyone, for those of you just joining us, a two-year-old little boy, Noah Chamberlain, missing. White male, blue eyes, blonde hair, just 2 feet tall. He only weighs 25 pounds. Noah Quander with me, WREG on the scene. Noah, what can you tell me about how Noah went missing?
Well, he went missing last Thursday. He was hiking with his grandmother, with his four-year-old sister, right behind their house in a very, very wooded area. The grandmother told the sheriff that she turned her back to check on the four-year-old for a quick second. She turns around, and then she finds out that the two-year-old went missing at that point. And so there is a mad dash to find him ever since then.
Okay, I don't understand what you're saying, Michael Quander. Michael, you're saying that the grandmother takes Noah, the two-year-old, and the four-year-old sister for a walk, basically a nature walk. They were not on a hiking trail, so to speak. They were just walking through a path in the woods behind their home. It's an extremely rural area. And then the grandmother turns her attention to the four-year-old for how long? Because how did a two-year-old get away that quickly?
Well, that's the question that everyone has been asking here, and we have not gotten very clear details from the sheriff. He's been giving us very short interviews out here. We've been trying to push him for some more answers as to what this story is as of right now, but a lot of things in the story, not all the way adding up, and people definitely have some questions about that right now.
With me, Michael Quander joining us, WREG. Also with me, Keith Shirley joining us. Keith, thank you so much for being with us. For those of you taking a look at little Noah's face right now, the temperatures are plunging to just 8 degrees in the Tennessee mountains. This little boy was out for a walk with his grandmother and his four-year-old big sister. She turns the attention to the four-year-old sister. The two-year-old wanders away. Nobody can find the baby. Keith Shirley, what can you tell me about the search? I understand it started small, but now it's gotten big.
The search has gone on last night. 450 volunteers came through between 5:45 and about 3 o'clock this morning. And that's been the pace regularly as they search. And it is a difficult area to traverse. This is timberland country. And so you have trees that have been shed for timber. You have stumps. Some of those stumps have rotted. So you have sinkholes, gullies, ravines. You have water in the area. This is a very rugged area to traverse through. And the way that it has been described to me that the events were taking place is the grandmother and the two children were out for a walk in this area. And as you're walking along, the children run ahead, they run behind you, they're running around. You know they're there, but you're not consciously watching every move because there's no danger in the area. And so it was under these type of circumstances that Noah disappeared.
Michael Quander joining us. What is the temperature tonight? Is it actually going to be 8 degrees?
It's going to be pretty cold. Last night it got as cold as 15 degrees out here. And they're also expecting a possibility of sleet, maybe some flurries out here. And so it's a very big concern about where this little boy could be and for volunteers that could be going back out to search tonight.
Michael, how far away was the grandmother, Noah, age 2, the sister, age 4, from the family home? Because they had gone into the woods to go just hiking around, a little nature walk. These are very young children. He's just two. How far have they gotten from the home when he goes missing?
Well, you know, they also had, this is another detail that we're still waiting to get clear information from the sheriff on. They have not told us exactly how far the distance was away from the home and exactly when the grandmother, I guess, realized and reported this. We were told that she reported it around 1:19 the Thursday afternoon. So you have to imagine that it was still daylight out there and they still were not able to find her.
You know, this is getting extremely murky to me, Keith Shirley, the news director, 101.5. Keith, because she reports the child missing at 1:19. I imagine that she tried to do her own search when she realized he was gone. Why were the children with the grandmother that day?
The children were dropped off that day with the grandmother, we are told, because the mother was going shopping. It was not uncommon for the grandparents to have the children and for the children to visit there. It was not uncommon. It was an unusually warm day that day. It was 61, 62 degrees. And this is a farm, and again, it's rural area, so it's not like you're leaving and there's a nature park behind you. This is rural, rugged territory.
So this is really like just going outside, and they are playing in the woods behind the home. Back to you, Mike, Keith Shirley, do you know why they are not giving the detail as to how far away from home the baby goes missing?
Well, I think that would be a difficult question to answer because there wasn't a particular point, from what I understand, where the baby goes missing. It's not like there's a point where you say, okay, now the child is missing. If you're out in your yard and you're playing with your children and you look up and you see them and they're playing and they run in and they run out, there's no real point that you go, they're missing because they're just in the backyard playing.
I know, but if I'm with them, I know where I am. When I realize the child is missing. I mean, to this day, I remember in Baby Sarus when I looked around and I didn't see John David, my son, okay? Of course, he had just gone one row over, but I can remember rooted to my spot when I looked both ways and he wasn't there. So I can't understand why we can't put our finger on where the baby was, where the grandmother was, when the child goes missing. Let me ask you this. Keith Shirley, have scent dogs, tracking dogs been called in?
The best dogs and some of every resource that is available, not just in Tennessee, but in the southeast and around the country have been brought in. State officials, Tennessee wildlife officials, Department of Corrections officials that track escaped convicts, federal officials have come in to help and interview people. There have been every resource in the area that is available, helicopters from the military personnel, a plethora of services on the ground.
Well, there's trails all over the area, and he was on a trail when he went missing. We have searched all around those trails. I wouldn't be afraid to say there was hundreds of miles of trash.